jump on, jump on, jump on. Hey, you crazy kid. Hey!
Medical research shows having hope is linked with good health. And nowhere is that message more exemplified than with the Lammy family. Father Matthew, Mother Alice, and their six children have learned through an incredible experience the importance of hope.
All of a sudden, when I saw the hospital where we were having our ultrasound clinic, I just felt really nervous all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. And I told Matthew, this hospital looks scary. And that's all I kind of thought in my mind.
Alice was pregnant with her sixth child. And although all her other children had no health problems, this pregnancy would be different.
The first thing that the technician looked at was the brain. And kept looking at the brain, down the back, the brain, down the back, down the back. Kept looking there, and I didn't think anything of it until all of a sudden I saw this big sack on the back of her back.
It was spina bifida, a birth defect that causes an opening in the neural tube, allowing the spinal cord to bulge outward.
We've seen a few ultrasounds, we know what to expect, but I did not expect this.
Spina bifida can cause walking difficulties and even paralysis, bladder problems, and other health issues, and it produces an excessive buildup of fluid in the brain, which can result in brain impairment.
My first thought was, we can't bring home a baby with an open back because our house is not clean enough. The kids will not keep their hands off the baby, and the germs are going to go right up to the brain, and she's going to get an infection and die.
In standard treatment, a spina bifida baby is operated on immediately after birth. Surgeons repair the hole and place a shunt in the brain to drain off excess fluid. But there's no way to reverse any damage already done.
That fluid on the brain then can cause learning and cognitive development issues and those types of long-term problems.
Dr. William Goodnight is the Lammy's obstetrician at UNC Healthcare, one of a growing number of medical centers that perform an innovative new treatment. Instead of waiting for the baby to be born, doctors operate in the womb. But it can be risky, both for the baby and the mother.
The biggest complication that we have from the surgery is delivering prematurely. That oftentimes requires mom to be on bed rest or significantly reduced activity.
Matthew and Alice considered the risks, but in the end, Alice wanted to undergo fetal surgery.
I saw this as an opportunity to help my baby, and I saw it as an opportunity to rise up in courage that I'd never had to before and sacrifice for her.
Fetal surgery is usually performed between the 5th and 6th month of pregnancy. Mothers should be at least 18 years old and healthy, and the fetus must not have any other complications.
The Lammies met those requirements, and Alice had her surgery on April 10th, 2012. She and the baby made it through, but Alice wasn't prepared for what came after.
And I remember saying, I felt like I was suffocating.
And so she got to the point where she couldn't lift her hand, and she became flush, and I said, oh my gosh, I'm losing my wife.
Alice had fluid on her lungs. Once that was corrected, she was hit with another hurdle.
It was extremely painful. I had an incision from hip to hip, and all of my insides felt like they had been shuffled as they had to pull out the uterus and put it back in. So it was just sore and swollen all around. And then I felt the weight of a baby on top of an incision.
Doctors do pull out the uterus during the procedure. Then a small incision is made to reach the baby's back and repair the hole. Alice and Matthew returned home after a week and hoped the growing child would remain in her uterus for as long as possible. This is the time when families need a great deal of support. One of the most pressing concerns for the Lammies was, who's going to take care of their other 5 children while Matthew goes to work and Alice remains on bed rest?
We had moms and aunts and sisters come. And so I was going between work at NC State, going to Chapel Hill Hospital, and here, going back and forth. And it all became the game of keep hope inside.
Keeping hope inside. They had named this special baby Hope.
When Matthew came across the name Hope, we said, yes, that's it, that's it.
Yeah.
And she has taught us so much about hope.
So they prayed to keep hope in the womb and to keep hope in their hearts that all would turn out for the best. But that hope would be tested yet again. Alice's water broke early, not uncommon for mothers who've undergone this procedure. She was rushed to the hospital, where she remained for 3 weeks until delivery day, June 5th. As Alice prepared to bring hope into the world, Matthew waited anxiously, alone.
I had never felt so alone in my life. For the first time in my life, my hands were shaking. So once again, I prayed and I said, I need help.
Matthew's prayers were answered when the doctors finally brought him hope.
I dropped to my knees and I said, Hope, you've come. You've made it. It was the joy to see that child.
With Hope delivered and Alice recovered, they were able to bring their 5-pound bundle of joy home to see her new brothers and sisters.
Oh, they just thought she was a doll. They just kept holding her. Oh, she's so tiny. She's so cute. Get her, get her. You get Sissy.
No.
Yay, she got you. Good job, Sissy.
Hope is now a playful, energetic 3-year-old. She can not only walk, but run.
No, don't let her get you.
She still has complications from spina bifida, including issues with her digestive tract. But the surgery corrected fluid buildup in her brain, so she never needed a shunt after birth.
One, two,
mommy.
Fetal surgery is a tremendous advancement in medicine, but it is a long journey for those who go through it. Yet despite the risks and the pain, the Lammies say having hope has changed their lives.
Life has a purpose, and hope came with a purpose. Have hope, because there are some times when I was in those, when I was shaking, that's when I would lose hope.
Our worst demons are in our minds sometimes, just the doubt and the fear and the what ifs. I had fears. I was worried that I wasn't going to make it through the surgery, and it's okay to be afraid. But you do it anyway with the hope it will work out, and that's courage.
And it's worth it. Hope is worth it.